Last week, I posted a video about Where Winds Meet, where I mainly focused on the standard version of the game. However, many of you asked about the light version, along with questions on how to switch APIs. So in this video, I'll answer some of those questions and take a quick look at the light version to see how it compares both visually and in terms of performance to the standard one. But first, let's start with the API question and how to switch between the DirectX versions. Normally, when you launch the game on Steam, a small window appears allowing you to choose between the X11 and the X12. But if you check the box that says always use this option, that window will stop showing up. To bring it back, simply right-click the game, go to Properties, and look for Selected Launch Option. From there, you can set it to ask when starting the game to make the window appear again, or you can force the game to always launch with either the X11 or the X12. Let's move on to the light version. This version isn't available on Steam. As far as I know, the only way to install it is through the game's launcher, which you can download from the official website by clicking Play PC Now. This launcher gives you the option to install either the light version, the standard version, or both if you wish. Here we can see the first difference, which is the install size. The light version requires around 68GB compared to 110GB for the standard version. But as we'll see shortly, the size saving comes at the expense of reduced visual fidelity. When it comes to the graphics menu, all settings and the light version max out at high. More interestingly, there is a shadow quality setting, which does not exist in the standard version. As the name implies, this controls the resolution and quality of shadows, and testing it across multiple scenes shows negligible performance differences between low and high. When comparing it to the standard version, the high option delivers identical shadow quality, but as expected, the Ultra preset in the standard version still offers noticeably higher shadow fidelity. Now, the most noticeable visual difference between the standard and the light versions is the overall quality of textures and assets. As you can see here, the light version uses lower resolution textures and simplified assets. But that's not all. In several areas, there are fewer scattered objects and noticeably less environmental detail in the light version. Global illumination looks almost identical between the two, but again, many decorative elements and objects are missing on the light build. There are few more differences I spotted. The first one is related to artificial light sources. Notice how the light version is missing the candlelight present in the standard version. The second difference involves the animation and object's movement. For example, some trees are completely static in the light version, whereas they move properly in the standard one. The same applies to this water mill, which rotates only in the standard version. So at this point, I think you get the idea. The light version sacrifices texture quality, asset complexity, and a lot of environmental detail. But the only remaining question now is how much do these visual sacrifices actually improve performance? Before jumping into the comparison, I want to point out that in the standard version, I am using these settings, which roughly matches the quality preset of the light version. I am also adding the optimized settings from the previous video to the comparison. Here in this village, the light version averages a 31% performance uplift over the standard version, and around 16% over the optimized settings. However, in open wilderness areas like here, the gain shrinks significantly. This makes sense as most of the light version's visual cuts affect asset quality and environmental detail. The performance difference outside dense areas like villages, towns, and cities is much smaller. So overall, I only recommend the light version if you are using an older GPU with a limited amount of VRAM. Since most modern mid-range or even low-end GPUs should be able to run the standard version without any issues. And that's it, that's the end of this quick video. A huge thank you to all my Patreon supporters and big thanks to you as well for watching until the end. Feel free to like or dislike the video. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future content. And hopefully I'll see you all in the next one.